So Ishida Sui, the author of Tokyo Ghoul and Chojin X, did an interview because of the German launch of Chojin X. And this interview is stuff that we kind of already knew, or was out there, but just not really confirmed. And it's a very informative interview. Like, it really does put a lot of, like, clarification to everything, because it's been years since Tokyo Ghoul came to an end. And I think what's going to get everybody to really be interested in this article, and I'm definitely going to use it as the title, is that Ishida Sui doesn't think Tokyo Ghoul was a success. And this is a legitimately, like, interesting topic, because obviously the final stretch of Tokyo Ghoul is always up for heavy debate in the community for Tokyo Ghoul, and I even talked about it when Tokyo Ghoul reached an end. And having years to sit down and think about it and even reread those chapters of Tokyo Ghoul, I legit do like the ending of TG. It was a good ending. It wasn't the best ending, but it got everything I wanted, and it concluded everything that needed to be concluded, so to speak. And so, in terms of the grand scheme of things, I was very satisfied. And obviously, there is those that weren't, which is valid and completely fine. But hearing the author, the man behind the curtain, the man that writes these manga, for instance, like Chojin X and Tokyo Ghoul and Tokyo Ghoul Re, saying that he did not feel Tokyo Ghoul was successful is legitimately shocking, because when we think about success, Tokyo Ghoul sold well. It was top charts when it was going, coming out. You know, the volumes were selling like hotcakes. I mean, it was a very popular manga. So in terms of success, I wouldn't say it was a failure in sales, but that's not what Ishida Sui is actually saying. He's actually talking about how he felt about it. And this interview, which I'm going to be going over, was in German, and thankfully someone did decide to translate it. Now, I don't know how accurate these translations are, but I do want to be diving into this interview and kind of talk about it. And one of the critical points that everybody's obviously wanting to talk about is just, why does he say he doesn't feel it's a success? So I guess the big thing here is that the start of the interview kind of talks about Ishida's early life, you know, what kind of got him into pursuing manga, becoming a mangaka and all that, and, you know, how he was inspired by Kentaro Mura, Yoshihiro Togashi, two big names within the industry. Also, how he worked for Yasuhisa Hara, which was, you know, the author of Kingdom, which still to this day does not actually have, you know, a English, you know, publication in the West, which is just wild to me with how popular the series is. But anyways, the point is that we get a lot of his early life, kind of what inspires him, you know, like different things of why he's created Chojin X like he's done. For instance, talking about how, like, you know, he feels like he's more free and not as restricted with Chojin X, because with Tokyo Ghoul is a very restricted world with a lot of restrictions, like the CCG. Like, if anyone remembers, you know, just like how the world of Tokyo Ghoul worked, you know, ghouls really couldn't be friends with humans, and because of just how the society was built, and there was some very strict rules that were in place there, so it makes a lot of sense why Ishida would feel that. He felt bounded by the rules he made with his world, and he had to follow those rules unless he wanted a retcon. So when you think about everything, it's very fascinating just to kind of get an insight of why he created Chojin X like he's doing now, because he wanted to be more free, less restricted with his writing. And on top of that as well, he goes a little bit more in length with it, with stuff he's added in, like retro stuff and all, like you can see the arcade machines. It's really cute, and it really just goes to show the little tendencies of, you know, Ishida Sui, and how he actually wrote even Tokyo Ghoul and Chojin X. Now, we get into the design of the characters as well, like his main character of Chojin X and why he did this and all that, the reason for his designs and everything. I think this is very fascinating, and this is obviously stuff that you would already pick up on and know if you read Chojin X, but it's nice to just hear from the man himself kind of mention this and why he designed this character like that, and how he can also kind of get into his mind and understand him. It's very reminiscent of Kaneki Kim, like from Tokyo Ghoul, the MC. Like, this right here, this is just very Ishida Sui. I wanted him to remain a character that, as I am now, I can understand his frame of mind. I think that really categorizes Ishida Sui's mentality with writing characters, especially his main characters. Like, I think anyone that read Tokyo Ghoul is now currently reading Chojin X can agree that when you follow these stories of these characters, like, you know, Kaneki, you're able to understand what they're thinking even without dialogue. Hell, there was moments within Tokyo Ghoul Re to where Kaneki had an entire chapter where he didn't speak, and it was like a speechless chapter, but you knew what was going on and what the characters were thinking because of just how well-written the characters were, thanks to Ishida Sui. So I think that hearing this, it's nice to see his mentality has not changed with how he writes his characters, and that they still stay the same. Like, his writing is still the same. I love that. As, like, an old-time fan of Ishida Sui, it's nice to hear that confirmation from him. Now, moving on into the next thing, we gotta talk about just kind of, like, you know, motivations and why he feels like, you know, Tokyo Ghoul was not a success. And what kind of led towards the ending. So here's the question. With Tokyo Ghoul, you achieved quite the success. We heard that you felt very pressured afterwards due to said success. How did you overcome that pressure while working on Chojin X? How did you manage the great expectations of your fans? And this is what Ishida, you know, responded with. I don't remember that I ever said there was pressure to succeed, but I'm not sure if I remember correctly. Did I say that? I don't know. I don't think so, that I ever said that. But offer and pressure, I think that's a very profound topic. For that reason, I've already thought about it once in my own way. So this is definitely a topic that he has sat down and really just, you know, thought to himself, probably just sitting alone and thinking about how he feels about that pressure. As far as premise is concerned, I don't really consider Tokyo Ghoul a success. For me, success is when I get the feeling that I drew something good. When I think about it, I don't actually demand for it to be well-received in society or that many people like it, so success for me is whether I can praise myself for it or not. And then continuing the conversations, this is the same question and he's carrying on. When I think about it, I don't really demand for it to be well-received in society or that many people like it. And when I think even further about it, I think that I find it rather difficult to engage with my readership. This is fascinating. It basically shows his overall connection with the fans, you know, people that actually read his story. To be completely honest, I don't really have a concrete idea of what type of people enjoy reading my manga. And honestly, that's fair. I'll comment on that in a second, like more into that. I feel like if I dwell on it too much, I'll try more and more to just cater to my readers to the point it might affect my drawings and make them seem odd. Therefore, the only thing I'm asking from myself is self-laudation. Anything else beyond that is appreciated and I think thanks. So this is fascinating. Because we obviously get a huge insight to why he feels Tokyo Ghoul wasn't, you know, a success, but also how he feels about his fans, his readership, and how he kind of tackles that. It's fascinating. He has, like, this wall or barrier that he kind of puts up, but he also admits that if he lets that barrier down, he does allow his readers to kind of influence him to a point to where he will change his manga's direction just to make them happy. That's fascinating. It basically implies that, like, if a character that, you know, he might want to kill off, it's, like, too much, the readers could probably force him, or not force him, inspire him, or influence him in a way to keep that character alive, so to speak. So when you really think about just, like, everything that is written here, it is implied that maybe at some point or another, for him to kind of come to this conclusion, he might have done this for Tokyo Ghoul. He might have done this for the original, or and obviously this doesn't confirm that, it doesn't, but we could just read in between the lines, so to speak. We don't know, but once again, it's a little bit informative. It lets us know how he feels about his audience, and he even admits himself he doesn't really know what his audience wants, like, you know, what they actually do or why they enjoy reading his manga. And like I said, I think this is fair, and the reason for that is because when you think about the just the grand scheme of things for Tokyo Ghoul, okay, just not even figured Chojin X, but Tokyo Ghoul and how he wrote it, there's a lot of different fans that got into Tokyo Ghoul, okay? You had the shonen fans that liked action and battle. You had those that wanted a very psychological story, those that just wanted edgy manga, and then those that wanted the in-between-the-lines of character studies with some of the aspects within the world, and then even the world-building as well, and a commentary on real-world events too in its own way, just based in the Tokyo Ghoul universe. I think that there was a lot of different readers that was drawn in to Tokyo Ghoul, and there was not just one group that was reading it. Because I remember while reading the series and reviewing and doing reactions to the series, that I remember there was times where there was like a full talking chapter, like just a straight up conversation chapter, and people would be upset with that because there was no battling, no action. And then there would be chapters that had action, like full-on battles, and there would be some that really loved it, and then some being like, I cannot follow this, I don't understand this, I don't like this, and just get back to what's going on with the talking or whatever. And there was always this back and forth between, you know, these chapters. And I feel like Ishida Sui really kind of understood that. That his fans just had many different things they wanted, and he really didn't know what to do because he didn't know what everyone actually wanted. And he couldn't really cater to everyone. And that was a big thing. And I feel like even if he doesn't directly state it, there probably is some pressure to a degree to make his fans a little bit happy, even though he does go on record to state that he doesn't think about it too much and he just does what he wants and he, you know, is motivates himself to draw what he's happy with. I still think to some degree with just the way this interview is done and what he talks about is that at one point he probably was trying to cater to fans, but obviously it didn't work out. But anyways, let's continue reading the interview. So basically, he talks about, you know, once again, more about like the success of Tokyo Ghoul and the pressure. That's why the only thing I could do is face my own obstacles. And I think that's the biggest pressure weighing me down. Basically, his own fears, his own negativity, I would assume from that. I still haven't really overcome that pressure. So when I'm drawing manga, regardless of whether it's about Ghoul or Chojin, I'm facing the same hurdles and pressure. If the things I've drawn after overcoming my hurdles is liked by the people, then I'm happy. I think that's the first time ever I've been able to connect with my readers. So what we get here is that Ishida overcoming these hurdles, these obstacles, which is these pressures or these invisible hurdles to everybody else, but to him it's real, like it's a big deal that he has to deal with. It's being satisfied with his work, being satisfied with what he puts out. And it's not about if other people like it, it's about, you know, does he enjoy what he's working on? Does he enjoy what he is doing? Is he satisfied with the conclusion? And that is what's most important to him. And then once he's done with that, and if he does look at the fan reaction and they enjoy it, he's even happier. Like, it's like a cherry on top of a very good cake. So I think that this is legitimately an interesting little dialogue with Ishida, kind of discussing how he felt about, you know, Tokyo Ghoul, but also how he's currently feeling about Chojin X. Now, another thing, he goes on record to talk even more. He talks about inspiration. Basically, where do you draw your own inspiration from when drawing, and is there maybe a certain right that helps you? And he says, inspiration. I'm not really sure about that. If I think about wanting to draw something, I just draw it. It's not often the case that I see something and then I feel the urge to draw something like a right. I also don't have that. But when I haven't drawn for a long period of time, my proportions start to become messy. In that case, I fill a page with quick sketches to warm myself up for work on the manuscripts. By doing that, I reduced the effort to touch something up because it wasn't drawn well. Now, this next one is pretty interesting. This gives insight into Ishida's life and how he works, his work schedule, so to speak. And before I go any further and really read this, I think everybody at this point in time knows how mangaka are, that they are overworked, tired. Oda himself, obviously, like he sleeps 4 to 5 hours and works pretty much the entire day. You know, there's a lot of stories, and I've talked about this continuously on my channel, where mangaka overwork themselves to the point to where they break their body. And obviously, at one point, Ishida probably was maybe tired, overworked, or whatever. And even though he doesn't directly state it here, like he does not say it here, you can still assume that he does think he was working too hard at one point, because he talks about the weekly schedule, even though, like I said, he doesn't directly state it. But let's read this, okay, before I go any further. Since I currently don't have any assistants, I usually work completely alone. Lately, I wake up in the afternoon or late afternoon and then draw maybe 10 hours. After that, I read books until I fall asleep or watch movies. If I can't fall asleep, I'll work a little further. If I'm making really good progress or if I really want to hand something over, I draw for 20 to 30 hours at a time. That's ridiculous. But when I'm not doing well or when there's no hurry, I draw about 5 hours and spend the rest of the time jogging, walking, playing games, reading books, or watching movies. But since my mind is mostly on work, there are hardly any hobbies I really can relax with. And then someone's like, do you draw it traditionally or digitally? Which drawing tools do you use when drawing Chojin X? And above all, which ones do you specifically use for which steps? He says, I draw completely digitally with Clip Studio by Eclipse. I work with 10 to 20 main brushes and side pens, plus around 100 that I use occasionally, plus around 50 shortcuts. With this, I switch between tools and action commands so I can use so many functions. Now, the last part of this interview, which is very fascinating, he talks about, you know, just like how his page limit is in the weekly schedule, which is what I alluded to earlier on. Weekly series have a total page count of 8 to 20 pages per week, but I've always thought, personally, I could probably draw something better when I'm not bound to a specific pace or page limit, and I have the possibility to decide when to take time off when I need it. I don't know anything about reactions to the announcement because I didn't see them. So basically, to kind of clarify this, the question that was being asked is that when we heard that Chojin X, Ishida Sui's new series, was not going to be bound by a set weekly release schedule and he could just make his own schedule online, everybody got happy, even myself. I made a video on it. I thought this was really good. It was the future of writing manga because it allowed authors to pace themselves. And he even says himself, he's able to pace himself, take breaks when he wants, and he's not bound by a certain page limit, so he's able to write what he wants within a given chapter. I think this is a legitimate, nice insight to show just he does not like weekly releases. He doesn't like that. He does not like it whatsoever, and he's really satisfied with just how he's able to present Chojin X. So it does seem, in some degree, he is a lot happier than how he was with Tokyo Ghoul, because it was releasing weekly. Tokyo Ghoul was a weekly release series. That's insane, especially if you were reading it at the time. The art quality was insane for Tokyo Ghoul. It's insane to think how he was able to do that every single week, pretty much almost nonstop. So, overall, this is a legitimately interesting interview. Like, we get him talking about how he likes to play boring games just to chill. You know, I think that Ishida obviously has grown a lot as an author over the years, and just seeing this interview makes me happy for him. It's clear that things are going a lot better. He's able to reflect on things of the past, and he still has a little bit of hurdles to overcome, but legitimately he is doing better, and he's very satisfied, I think, with his work at the time. But, yeah, I really think this is just a very informative video, or a very informative interview, and hopefully this is an informative video for all of you guys, and you enjoy it. But, yeah, I wanted to talk about this interview, because I know there is a lot of people that watch my content that really love Tokyo Ghoul, and I wanted to share it with all of you. So, you all have a fantastic day or night wherever you live. Be safe, stay healthy, Chibi out.